In his vision of the tree of life, Nephi beheld a virgin most beautiful and fair above all other virgins, who would become the mother of the Son of God after the manner of the flesh. Interestingly, while other Book of Mormon prophets clearly identified this virgin as Mary, Nephi never did. It appears that Nephi instead drew attention to the meaning behind Mary's name, which most likely derives from an Egyptian root word which means love or desire. On several occasions, these terms are used throughout Nephi's account of Mary. Notably, the only time they are used together is when they describe the tree of life. This seems to be more than a coincidence because there is good reason to associate the tree of life with Mary herself. Just as the tree of life bore precious fruit, Mary bore Jesus Christ. Also, the association of the tree of life with a holy or divine mother figure was present in ancient Israelite religion. By describing the tree of life as the love of God, which was most desirable above all things, it appears that Nephi linked the sacred tree with the Egyptian word underlying Mary's name. Elsewhere in the Book of Mormon, Mary is described as a precious and chosen vessel. This is meaningful because the fruit that Mary bore, the Son of God, was likewise described by Nephi as being most precious and most desirable above all other fruits. What better way did Nephi have of emphasizing God's love than by drawing attention to Christ's mother, who, by the very meaning of her name, was love personified, and whose mortal mission was to bear the most desirable and precious gift of God? And now you know why.